Good afternoon. Now I will bring the presentation with a topic, most common mistake on MikroTik configuration. As you saw on the flag, I came from Indonesia. This little bit about me, my name, my certification, and the company, and the assignment at Network Operating Center. This where I came from West Sumatra, Padang there. So Kuala Lumpur here. The distance is about an hour, 10 minutes only from my place to come here. It's not far away. This a little picture about West Sumatra. The dark blue. And about the company, the place that I work for, about ATS. ATS is a short form from Asia Technology Solution, established since 1998, data center since 2006, internet service provider since 2014, and the coverage area is Tangerang, Jakarta, North Depok, Bekasi, Karawang, Purwakarta. And lastly, MikroTik Training Center. This our coverage area. Yeah, there is a tower picture, the black one. So many there. This our coverage area in Jakarta and surround Jakarta City. Services. We have a dedicated internet connection, broadband internet connection, interconnection, local loop, server hosting or colocation, web email hosting, managed service, and others, depending on the customer request. How to reach us? This is our address, the office address, the phone, website, and emails. Objective, back to the topic. This to help you understand the diagnose most common RouterOS configuration issue. Show the proper application of the router as feature to avoid configuration issue. Encourage you to use latest router OS version and newest feature. Presentation material. This presentation will consist of most popular problem compiled sent to MikroTik forum discussion and groups. Example are compressed. Combine, simplify for presentation purposes. This presentation will show configuration issue and improve configuration. So this is the first problem. If you see here in the red box, the space only 300 kilo. This the situation I create on my lab, not the real situation. But I saw a similar condition on a client, where they put some file or backup or they run some other services that the none full and the log say none full, cannot do any other services. That we see here, most of the installation put the main package. Main package that consists advanced DHCP, the rack, box, hotspot, IP6, MPLS, PPP, and others, that most of the services will not use by customer. Example, IP6, MPLS, routing, mostly will not use. PPP only when the customer want to use VPN. MPLS, we can say 90% customer will not use MPLS or OSPF. Let's say office, home user will not use it. But why the services stay there and consume the storage space on the router? Problem analysis. None on the router full, and an error message appear on the log router. Diagnosis, system resource, so free space about half meg or less. System packet show almost all packet installed even if never been used, such as IPv6. Most of us will not use it. maybe another 10 years we'll use it. Reason, packets that do not use, although have been disabled, still need space on the NAND router. See the package management. We have so many package management. This capture from MTCNA class. We have advanced tools, Kalia, DHCP, hotspot, blah, blah, blah. We can see the MPLS we use for MPLS and traffic engineering. Routing only for dynamic routing, RIP, BGP, USPF, static routing stay on system. So if the customer only use static routing, why we put routing on the router? If we customer don't use IP6, why we put IPv6 there? And etc. Correct implementation, remove unneeded package like Kalia, GPS, IPv6, MPLS, NTP, OpenFlow, TR069, and other packets that are likely not be used. Don't use bundle package like show below, because the individual packet that are included in the above bundle packet cannot be deleted. They can only be disabled, so that still occupy space in storage NAND. It strongly recommend that you use extra package, because we can add and or delete each individual package that we use. So when customer need OSPF, we add routing. When customer need VPN, we add PPP. That's it. See, on bundle package, without this is a fresh installation with using a bundle package. The space, free space, 7.9 meg. But after we use extra package, it's increased become 8.3 meg. 400 meg extra space we have on the router. Yeah. This is the problem number one. Number two, this most common installation in our customer as well, that done by technician. There is one router, R1, R2, R3, R4, and etc. They put NAT on each router. They run DHCP on each router. So on the picture, we see R1 has NAT and internet on DHCP server. R2 has NAT to R1 and DHCP server. This is wrong configuration. Problem, computer that connected to R1 will not be able to do peer-to-peer communication to computer that connected to R2 because they are netted on R2. Separate the DHCP server between R1 and R2 cannot doing firewall on R1 for computer connected to both router, R1 and R2, unless the same firewall installed again on R2, set this double effort. Yeah. Correct implementation, take out ether 2 on R1 from bridge, allocate P2P IP address from ether 2 at R1 to ether 1 at R2, put static load from R1 to R2, add DHCP relay from R1 to R2, so DHCP list at R1 will contain all lists both on R1 and R2. The firewall configuration is only on router 1. Router 2 doesn't need firewall anymore because taken over by router 1. Next problem, wireless. Who can see what's wrong on this configuration? This is the most configuration done by most of the engineer. Who can see the what's wrong here? Yeah. There are two mistakes here. First, 2 GHz BGN. That's the first mistake. The second mistake, channel 2040 MHZ-CE. Yeah. Because most of the gadget is not old fashioned anymore. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I saw that on Apple as well. Yeah. For home user, that's fine, no problem here. But for office user, this will make more problem. We will see after. The second problem is 2040 megahertz because most of the gadget only support 20 megahertz. Not many support 40 megahertz. If the API use 40 megahertz and the client, one client use 20 megahertz, all client will go to 20 megahertz. This is a problem. Problem analysis. By using 2040 MHz band, the availability channel only 7, not 11, the available channel. When we go to 20 only, we can see 1, 2, 3 until 11. But if we go to 2040, it's only available 1 through 7. 8 to 11 missing. Most of the client device does not support 40 MHz band. Most of them. If all clients use 40 megahertz and then there is one client connected 20 megahertz, then everyone will be on 20 megahertz. I found this problem many times. Let's say two or three first connecting gadgets able to connect 40 megahertz, that's fine, no problem, but the fourth client connect 20 megahertz, the rest switch to 20 megahertz. Okay. Analysis two, this. Only the yellow one. Only one non-overlap channel left. The second channel cannot be used because go to beyond the limit. 2462 is go to beyond the limit, the border. By 20 megahertz, we can have three non-overlap channel, 1, 6, 11, but 40, only one. So if you have, at the house, no problem for home user. For office, big office, we have multiple access point, cannot use 2040. Because how we can add more access point if the first access point already using this and no more non-overlapping channel available, okay? This the spectrum analyze for 20 megahertz, 2.4 gigahertz. This spectrum for 40 megahertz, it's occupied before 1 and till 7. So if we put another channel, will be overlap. Okay. Another standard X02.11 wireless work network using GSMA CA. Standard B use 22 channel width. B using 22 megahertz, while A and G using 20 megahertz channel width. That's the difference. So standard wireless N using 20 or 40, but N can use 20, not 40, not only 40, but can use 20, can use 40. If you use 40, both device supported 40, then it will double the bandwidth. But if one connected 20, all the rest go to 20. Yeah. So this answer the question, B using 22, because B maximum 11 megahertz. G 20 megahertz, support up to 54 megahertz. N using 20 megahertz, if I'm not wrong, it can support about 65 megahertz. Yes, 65 megabit for data rate. Okay. Correct implementation like this, only using G only or GN if connected client device is not all device from earlier 2000. If there is one device earlier 2000 that only support B, then switch to BGN. Use channel width 20, disable extended channel on capsman to get better choice of non-available channel. If the distance between AP is close enough, reduce the TX power to force the client to move the AP. Okay. Next, who mostly use this? Yeah. We found so many people using this to block YouTube, to block Facebook also like this. Many people using this. About maybe 80% still use this. Yeah. They define the firewall protocol and then block on firewall. That's it. Yeah. This wrong configuration. What happened? Problem high CPU load, increased latency, packet loss, jitter, YouTube, Facebook will not going to block. Diagnosis, tool profile, high CPU load on layer 7. Reason, each connection is rechecked over and over again. Layer 7 is checked in wrong place and against all the traffic, especially when you use the plastic router like RB750, it will going to dead. Server, yeah. We see on layer 7, the definition, layer 7 protocol is a method searching for the pattern in HTTP, TCP, UDP stream. On trigger layer 7, collects next 10 package or 2 kilobyte of the connection and search for the pattern in the collected data. So we imagine when one people doing a huge download, let's say 20 megabyte, while layer 7 searching every 2 kilobyte, how the CPU works? Very heavy. Yeah. All layer 7 pattern available on the internet are designed to work only for the first 10 package or 2 kilobyte of the connection. Yeah. If we are the connection using more connection, like explained by Ahmad Madiansa, this connection 1, connection 2, connection 3, it's rechecked again and again on each connection. Yeah. This is the correct implementation. Maybe not many people know, but I tried this on the plastic router. It worked fine. By about 40 users connected to the router, we implement this, the CPU usage only 6% average, less than 10%, compared to what configured before, mostly 100%, this less than 10%. So I explained IP firewall mangle, add action, this block the new connection. So when we go to the internet, let's say go to YouTube, we tap www.youtube.com. That's become a new connection to the internet. So we capture the new connection, go to the DNS, we capture that package and block that. That's it. If the DNS got blocked, then the packet itself will not go through. Yeah. And then go to a MAC package, MAC connection, MAC package. Then on IP firewall, there are two lines here. The first one, chain forward. The second line for input. Forward is for customer that using external DNS. So my computer connected but using, let's say, DNS to Google or DNS to other server. So it's captured on forward chain. But if the computer connected using the DNS from the connected router, use the input chain. So it block the DNS connection first, and then the rest, the packet data will not go through. That's it. Any question? This presentation quite simple. That's only I want to explain. Any? No question? Okay, next, who want to reach me? This is my email, Twitter, Instagram. Can reach me here. I will try to answer as best as I can. That's it. Thank you. Thank you.